Hey everyone, what's going on? Joey here, and I am so excited for the season 4 finale of The Masked Singer. And I want to talk to you about who I think might win. And then on top of that, let's talk about season 5. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe, you turn on notifications, and you give this video a thumbs up. Let's get started. So before we dive into my guest, let's talk about season 5 of The Masked Singer. That's right. Earlier this week, it was announced that we are officially getting a season 5. According to Fox president Rod Wade, and I want to read this, well, it's not his president, he's the president of alternative entertainment and specials at Fox Entertainment. We're just going to call him the president just for the heck of it. He says, "This show brings joy to so many families across the country, especially during these troubling times. And we can't find a better way to get more celebrities dressed up in crazy costumes for an hour for pure fun every single week." And let me tell you, I agree. I am extremely excited that they renewed for the 5th season. But to be honest with you, it kind of wasn't a surprise. It wasn't. The main reason why is because according to the ratings, they get about 11 million people for some of these episodes. That's a lot of folks. I believe over Thanksgiving, it was, what, 10 million people watched? Granted, everyone was home, but still, I think the season premiere started off at 11.5 million. So not only is this show popular, it's staying popular during its entire run, which, of course, led to its spinoff, The Masked Dancer, which we'll talk about a little bit later. But let me just say this. I'm excited. I know you're excited. We don't really have too much information about the show. Anyone as of right now, there really is no information. We do know that judges are all coming back, including guest judges such as Joel, because we all love Joel. And, you know, by the way, if you don't know, Ken and Joel are hosting Fox's New Year's Eve. So make sure you tune in for that, because I'm assuming it's going to be extremely, extremely goofy. Now, I know a lot of you guys are saying, but when will it premiere? Do we have a premiere date? Do you have any idea? Well, if we follow the schedule like we did last year and compare it to The Masked Dancer, Masked Dancer is 8 weeks, we're assuming, which puts us probably somewhere at the end of February, which could mean that either we'll have the first episode maybe mid-February or the end of February if we want to follow that trait. Now, I know you're saying, but what about the Super Bowl? You know, in years past, it would be the Super Bowl happens and then The Masked Singer will go right into it. So it'd be a lead-in. Well, it's a little bit different this year. Fox is not hosting the Super Bowl, which means there's no lead-in. So they're not going to air it that day. It wouldn't make any sense. Plus, the Super Bowl is, what, the second week of February? And that would mean that there's still 2 or 3 weeks left of Masked Dancer? I don't know. It doesn't really work out. But this is all we know so far. And I don't know. Are you excited for that? Because to be honest with you, I am beyond excited. And I want to say this now because, you know, last year, when it came to the time where they said, "Hey guys, what kind of costumes would you like to see on the show?" Remember, the broccoli was being hidden by my Christmas lights. The broccoli was a brainchild of us here on YouTube. You know, I mentioned that I love broccoli. You guys doing my live streams Friday with the Continos, you guys made it a joke and kept bringing it up. And at the end of last season, one of our buddies here, Jacob, went ahead and drew me as the broccoli. And it looks just like the broccoli, including he had everything the same except for the outfit. The outfit was a little bit different. And the funny thing is that mine had headphones on its head, and he had a golden chain with headphones on it. So just like how we suggested that one for last season, I want to go ahead and suggest a crab for season 5. Hashtag season 5 crab, or hashtag crab mask singer. Let's use one of those ones. Or mask singer crab. What do you like? All right. Hashtag season 5 crab. Let's just go with that. No, mask singer crab sounds better. Okay. We're going to go with hashtag mask singer crab, because I want there to be a crab next season. Just like I said last year, if there's a broccoli on there, you know it's me. Well, if there's a crab this upcoming 5th season, then you would know it's me. Right? No? But anyway, let me know what kind of costumes you want to see for season 5. Let's go ahead and talk about the finale of season 4, Masked Singer. Well, it's going to be taking place not this Wednesday, just so you know. It's the following Wednesday. This Wednesday is a holiday sing-along. I know. We'll talk about that in another video. Right now, we have the Sun from Group A. From Group B, we have the Crocodile. And Group C, we have the Mushroom, who I still can't believe the Jellyfish lost out to. Well, I could say the same thing about the Seahorse, but hey, it is what it is. It's all about fun. Now, just looking at our characters, give me one second here. Let's redo this board, because it should be in order now, right? Now, we're no longer in groups, so we'll take down the Crocodile and switch them out with... Because remember, what we did for last season was we put them in order on how we thought they were going to win. So let's take these down, and hopefully the board doesn't come flying off, because it has happened in years past. Which, we have the Masked Dancer board behind here. So, we'll put the Jellyfish over here. Sorry, Chloe. By the way, did you see that Chloe did finally respond to Ken on Instagram? Here, I'll show you. Anyway, so that leaves us with the Sun, the Crocodile. Why am I saying like that? I have no idea. And the Mushroom. And I'm just realizing now that I still have all of their names written under the wrong character. So we can ignore that for now and erase it. We'll rewrite that in a minute. So remember that the Masked Singer, while it is an identity mystery show, at heart of it all, at its heart, it is a singing competition. So you have to look and say, out of these three, which ones had the better voice? Which one was a better entertainment on stage? I really need to drink more coffee. Which one was a better entertainer on stage? And which one just overall is the perfect showman? Now, I'm probably gonna go backwards in my order just because it makes sense to me. Obviously, looking at these three right here, which one do you think was the least talented, that's kind of really rude to say. Which one do you think had great talent, but deserves third place? And for me, and I think that's quite easy, that's the Mushroom. I feel like the Mushroom, while super talented, does not deserve to be in first or second. I can't believe that he won in two SmackDowns. I still can't believe it. So, Mushroom, I'm sorry, my friend. I'm giving you a third place. Let me know if you agree. Leaving us with two more guesses here. Two more guesses on who could be in the top, and to be honest with you, the Sun has been so phenomenal every single week. I mean, she legitimately made everyone cry the last episode. She did! And while I love the Crocodile, because we know it's Nick Carter, but I love the Crocodile, and he's very talented and overall a great performer. If I were to say who deserves it, it would definitely be the Sun. So, Crocodile here. I know someone's saying in the comment section, well, you finally fixed the board. Yeah, because some of them were crooked, and now I finally had the time to do it with you guys. And here we go. So this is my prediction. The Sun wins first, Crocodile second, and third, the Mushroom. Let me know if you agree with me in the comment section. And please make sure you subscribe, guys, because we are planning to do all the Masked Dancer stuff, and we're also going to carry a couple other TV shows. If there's another TV show you want me to carry, let me know in the comment section. Remember, anything kind of music-wise is kind of hard because we get copyrighted and then the video gets taken down. But let me know in the comment section, and I really would like to hit 40,000 by the end of the year. I know it's not realistic because we're, 7,000 away? But hey, if you haven't done so yet, please subscribe, turn on notifications, and give this video a thumbs up. I'm Joey, I'll see you later. Bye.